श्री पराशक्ति विद्यालय सीबीएसई क्लास 10 स्टैंडर्ड सब्जेक्ट बायोलॉजी।
गुड मॉर्निंग माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स। नेक्स्ट फॉर्मेशन ऑफ फॉसिल्स। फॉसिल्स आर फॉर्म्ड इन फॉक्स दैट इज वेरी वेट एंड मडी लैंड लावा एंड एट द बॉटम ऑफ डीप वाटर्स वेर द रेट ऑफ डीकेइंग एंड ऑक्सीजन कंटेंट इज लो। दीज कंडीशंस इज इन एनवायरमेंट Do not let the body of the organisms to decompose completely. We can get such body parts as fossils on digging the earth. In various cases, soft parts of the organisms get decomposed and only hard parts are left as fossils. Even the soft parts of the plants and animals are sometimes preserved as fossils like impressions, mold and cats. Then to know how fossils are formed layer by layer, let us go back to some 100 million years ago. The invertebrate organisms which lived in sea died and got buried in the sand on seabed. More and more sand got accumulated in the seabed and due to increased pressure and some chemical reactions, sandstone was formed. After millions of years, dinosaurs lived in the area. They died and their bodies got buried in the mud. This mud compressed above the rock which contained invertebrate fossils. After millions of years ago, horse-like creatures died in the same area and got fossilized in the rock above the earlier rocks. After many years, due to various factors like running water and wind, soil erosion occurred and it exposed the horse-like fossils. On digging deeper, we found fossils of dinosaurs and then invertebrates. Next, evolution by stages. Evolution is a continuous process which changes the characteristics of population with the passage of time. It is still at work. This is clear from the fact that we keep needing new antibiotics because widespread use of antibiotics such as penicillin has led to the development of resistant strains of bacteria. This justifies that evolution is still in action. The evolution of new organs due to adaptations occur in stages through natural selection. During the course of evolution, intermediate forms must have evolved before the evolution of full-fledged forms. The evidence shows that those intermediate stages were actually useful for the organisms possessing them, even if not in an obvious way. Next, evolution of eyes. The eye is a very important and complicated organ of animals. It has not been generated by a single DNA change, but have been created in stage over many generations. For example, the most primitive eyes are found in flatworms, example planaria. They are in fact eye spots sensitive to light, which provide survival advantages. In insects and cutaneous, both are arthropod. Both simple and compound eyes evolved. Perfect eyes developed in mollusk, for example octopus, but their eyes were different from vertebrate eyes in origin. This suggests that eyes in different organisms have separate evolutionary origin. Next, evolution of feathers. Sometimes an evolutionary change produced in an organism for one purpose becomes more useful for an entirely different function later on. For example, feathers were developed initially to provide insulation in cold weather, but later on they became useful for the function of flight in birds. This speciation speculation is based on the evidence of fossils record of some small dinosaurs which had feathers all over the body as well as over the forelimbs. These feathers in dinosaurs helped them in long jump, gliding and little in flying. The presence of feathers on birds shows that they were closely related to reptiles, that is dinosaurs, and have evolved from them. Next, evidence due to artificial selection. Artificial selection is the process by which humans select traits useful to them for improving the quality of domesticated plants and animals. Humans have been cultivating plants for more than 2000 years as food for themselves and animals. They select the individuals having the desired traits and separate them from others which do not have that character. The selected individuals are interpret for survival generations to produce new varieties with desired traits, characters. For example, wild cabbage plants have been under cultivated by farmers for over 2000 years as a food plant. Humans have generated different vegetables from it by selection. Examples: brocoli, cauliflower, kohlrabi and kale have been raised from wild cabbage through artificial selection. Some farmers wanted a leaf vegetables, so they breed cabbage. Some who wanted variety with arrested flower development produced brocoli. Some produced vegetable with sterile flower, that is cauliflower. Some farmers wanted swollen pods, so they developed kohlrabi. And other who wanted slightly larger leaves came up with the leafy vegetable kale. In a similar way, by artificial selection, animal breeders have been able to produce improved varieties of several domesticated animals such as dogs, horse, pigeon, poultry, cows, goats, sheep and pigs from their wild ancestors. Different varieties of crop like wheat, rice, sugarcane, cotton, vegetables, fruits, pulses and ornamental plants can be obtained in short time period by artificial selection. The presence of feathers on birds shows that they were closely related to reptiles, that is dinosaurs, and have evolved from them. Next, evidence due to artificial selection. Artificial selection is the process by which humans select traits useful to them for improving the quality of domesticated plants and animals. Humans have been cultivating plants for more than 2000 years as food for themselves and animals. They select the individuals having the desired traits and separate them from others which do not have that character. The selected individuals are interpret for survival generations to produce new varieties with desired traits, characters. For example, wild cabbage plants have been under cultivated by farmers for over 2000 years as a food plant. Humans have generated different vegetables from it by selection. Examples: brocoli, cauliflower, kohlrabi and kale have been raised from wild cabbage through artificial selection. Some farmers wanted a leaf vegetables, so they breed cabbage. Some who wanted variety with arrested flower development produced brocoli. Some produced vegetable with sterile flower, that is cauliflower. Some farmers wanted swollen pods, so they developed kohlrabi. And other who wanted slightly larger leaves came up with the leafy vegetable kale. In a similar way, by artificial selection, animal breeders have been able to produce improved varieties of several domesticated animals such as dogs, horse, pigeon, poultry, cows, goats, sheep and pigs from their wild ancestors. Different varieties of crop like wheat, rice, sugarcane, cotton, vegetables, fruits, pulses and ornamental plants can be obtained in short time period by artificial selection. Last, human evolution. Evolutionary history of humans has been studied by various tools like paleontology, that is the study of fossils, molecular phylogeny, DNA studies, time dating and excavating. The scientific study of tracing human evolution is called anthropology. The scientists involved in the study of human evolutions are called anthropologists. Fossil remains suggest that several human-like groups existed throughout the Europe, Asia and Africa during the last 4 million years or so. The earliest human type was Australopithecus africanus, which evolved nearly 5 million years ago. It had many ape-like characters but moved like man. Our genetic footprints can be traced back to African roots. Some of our ancestors left Africa about 10,000 years ago and spread across the planet. From Africa to West Asia, then to Central Asia, Eurasia, South Asia, East Asia, America, then Indonesia, Philippines to Australia, along with different evolutionary lines. In the course of their evolution, human beings went forwards and backwards, sometimes separate and sometimes in groups, and moved in and out of Africa. There is a great diversity of human forms and features throughout the world, which made people think about different human races on the basis of skin color, that is whitish, black, white and brown, but there is no biological basis of such a division. All human beings belong to a single species, that is Homo sapiens. That is, the Homo sapien is the zoological name of human. All of them have same chromosome number and a similar morphology of chromosomes. Okay, that's all this lesson. Okay, thank you students. Dear students, portions வந்து டிசம்பருக்குள்ளே கம்ப்ளீட் பண்ணணும்னு சார் சொல்லியிருக்காங்க, ஃபுல் போர்ஷன் வைக்கணும்னு. அதனால் ஸோ ஃபாஸ்ட்டாக எடுக்கணுங்கிறதுனால இதோட ஃபிஃப்த் லெசனை ஸ்டார்ட் பண்ணி விட்டுருக்கேன். நெக்ஸ்ட்டு அவர் என்விரான்மெண்ட் லெசன். த அவர் என்விரான்மெண்ட், த இன்ட்ரடக்ஷன் ஆஃப் த லெசன். த டேர்ம் என்விரான்மெண்ட் இஸ் டிரைவ்ட் ஃப்ரம் எ ஃப்ரெஞ்ச் வேர்ட் என்விரான், விச் மீன்ஸ் டு என்சர்க்கிள் ஆர் சரவுண்டு. Everything which surrounds us is collectively called environment. The environment around us constitutes a life support system. The environment can also be defined as the physical and biological surroundings of an organism where it lives, or the aggregate of surrounding variables which influence the existence or development of an organism. The physical, that is abiotic surroundings include land, water, air, atmosphere, light and temperature, whereas biological biotic surroundings include microorganisms, plants, animals and human beings. The abiotic and biotic constituents of the environment interact with each other, that is influence each other, and or interpretant. This interpretance among various constituents of environment maintain the balance in nature. All the living organisms, including humans, depend on the environment for all their needs like energy, air, water, food, clothing, transport, occupations and medicine. The uncontrolled activities of human beings are damaging the balance and the health of our environment day by day. We know that increasing human population and technological advancement have damaged the balance and health of environment, which is the basic cause of environmental problems. We have studied in class 9 how various factors of environment interact with each other and how different materials are cycled in the environment as biological cycles. Now we will study how human activities alter these cycles. In this chapter, we shall study the interaction between living organisms and their environment and two basic environmental problems, that is accumulation of waste and depletion of ozone layer. Next, ecosystem. We know that all living, that is biotic and non-living, abiotic things interact with each other to maintain the balance in nature. For example, the green plants' biotic components interact with air to get carbon dioxide and soil to get minerals and water to prepare their food through photosynthesis. Animals, including human beings, interact with plants to get food. In this way, a self-sustaining or functional units is formed, which is made up of living, that is biotic and non-living abiotic components. This unit is capable of independent existence and is called ecosystem. That is, the biotic components gives to abiotic components to the ecosystem. The term ecosystem was coined by A.G. Tansley in 1935. Ecosystem can be defined as a self-regulating and self-sustaining unit of living things like plants, animals and microorganisms, and the non-living environment. Non-living environment like soil, air and water which interact with each other. For example, a pond, a lake, a forest, a grassland, a desert and a sea. An ecosystem can be visualized as a structural and functional unit of nature. The size of ecosystem varies greatly from a small pond to a large forest or a sea or an ocean. For example, pond ecosystem and grassland ecosystem. A pond ecosystem consists of non-living components like air, soil, light, water and living components like aquatic plants and animals. A grassland ecosystem including the abiotic components like soil, air, light and water and the biotic components, that is the plants and animals living in the grassland. There are two basic processes conducted by the abiotic and biotic components in an ecosystem. Cycling of materials. It is the cycle of exchange of materials between living and non-living components of the environment. Next, flow of energy. The energy trapped by the green plants from the sun is passed on the other organisms. Types of ecosystem. Ecosystem can be classified on the basis of their nature, duration and size. On the basis of nature, ecosystem can be divided into two categories, natural ecosystem and artificial ecosystem. Natural ecosystem, an ecosystem which operates under natural conditions without the influence of human beings is called the natural ecosystem. There are two types of natural ecosystem, terrestrial and aquatic. First one, terrestrial ecosystem. It operates on land, for example, grassland, desert, forest, etc. Next, aquatic ecosystem. It operates in water, for example, pond, sea, ocean, etc. Artificial ecosystem. An artificial ecosystem which has been created and maintained by human beings is called artificial ecosystem. There are also called human-made anthropogenic ecosystems. For example, crop field, garden, park, large dam, fishery tank, aquarium, etc. Two categories, natural ecosystem and artificial ecosystem. Natural ecosystem, an ecosystem which operates under natural conditions without the influence of human beings is called the natural ecosystem. There are two types of natural ecosystem, terrestrial and aquatic. First one, terrestrial ecosystem. It operates on land, for example, grassland, desert, forest, etc. Next, aquatic ecosystem. It operates in water, for example, pond, sea, ocean, etc. Artificial ecosystem. An artificial ecosystem which has been created and maintained by human beings is called artificial ecosystem. There are also called human-made anthropogenic ecosystems. For example, crop field, garden, park, large dam, fishery tank, aquarium, etc.